Steve, let me just start with the sort of slightly positive news in here, the future expectations thing, which did pick up a bit. What does that tell you about as bad as the damage to consumer confidence and psyche is, that people maybe see, you know, the reopening chatter and think, okay, it's not going to be this bad forever?
Well, the Conference Board's Consumer Confidence Index is made up of the present situation analysis and then what consumers are thinking about the next 6 months. And what we've seen is a huge, stunning drop in the present situation. We're in a bad period. We know that. But you're right. The consumer expectations for the next 6 months is actually positive. It's gone up since last month. And that means that the consumers think that this is going to be a short-term read-in, you know, the next few months crisis, and that we're going to lead our way out of it. The Conference Board expects GDP to decline in the first quarter by about 5.8%, but in the second quarter, the Conference Board's projection is a minus 40% on an annualized basis. So these are really stunning numbers, but the consumers think, hey, we're going to get out of this. You know, so the key to all of this is safely reopening the economy.
It's interesting that you highlight that. I mean, it almost makes me wonder, you know, do I want to bet against the consumer? In other words, are the consumers going to be right that this, as bad as that minus 40 is, we are going to have a V-shaped rebound? The stock market's kind of telling you that right now. It's not going to be back to 100%, but we could be back to 80% by the end of the year. Or do you think that's mistaken, that none of us yet realize how bad this is, that it's going to go on for months and quarters and years longer, and it's just going to take a while for that reality to set in?
Well, remember, consumers depend heavily on in this index on what their current situation is and whether they've lost their job and what their wages are. And so this means that consumers expect to go back to work based on what's going on. But, you know, there are multiple scenarios out there, including this long U-shaped scenario or even a W-shaped scenario if there comes to be another outbreak in the fall. And that's the one that I'm most worried about. But we've got to get this thing going. You're not going to see a V-shaped recovery unless we safely open the economy. You could do every virtual business now. You can do a lot of geography, mm-hmm. except for the hot spots. You could go click and pick for every retail and restaurant, social distancing guidelines. The key to this is going to be some sort of safe harbor explanation or coverage for businesses that do open so that they don't have massive lawsuits in this thing.
Yes.
And then finally, we need liquidity. We've gotten some good liquidity going here, but I think it's going to need to be extended longer, at least through the end of the year here, to make sure that we get this thing going. If
sure.
that all happens, I think consumer confidence and consumer spending will rebound by the holidays.
Well, you know, we talk a lot about the liquidity on the show, whether it's coming from the Fed or Congress, but you mentioned the legality, Steve, and I think this is getting super interesting because this is going to come down in many ways to a big legal fight. You know, the Journal today was highlighting that a lot of states are trying to push more of the coverage onto insurance companies to handle workers' comp claims, even if you can't necessarily prove you got coronavirus. But if you're a frontline worker, they want you to stay on the job, obviously. They want to make sure that companies stay open. It sounds like the president might be mulling something like this in terms of food makers to make sure that they can keep going without having, you know, without facing a big legal threat. What more do you think should be done here?
Well, Kelly, this is a big risk because how does any employer say it's okay to come back to work here? And then if the trial attorneys are out there waiting for one person to get sick and then say that the company's liable for that, there has to be some sort of federally led safe harbor set of guidelines that everybody follows. Do they need masks? Do they make it voluntary? You know, whatever it is that says if you follow these guidelines, you cannot be liable for this. Otherwise, how does the CEO ever say it's okay to come back in the water here? I don't think that's possible. So this safe harbor thing is really, really important. But the extension of these loans are really important, too. Remember, they've issued this for an 8-week period, mm-hmm. but this is going to extend beyond 8 weeks. They should extend that 8-week period through the rest of the year. They should extend the forgivability period because you don't want to create a W where the 8 weeks start to come back and then people lay off again because the 8 weeks are up. So
no,
these are the kinds of things that need to be tweaked.
It's absolutely true. But before you go, I mean, I just wonder about the political will. Even getting this thing passed in the first place, that was always going to be the easiest time. Refilling it became a little bit of a political fight. Going back and refilling, extending, I just don't know if there's going to be the will, the way that people have criticized the recipients of the PPP program. We're really going to go back and say, yeah, sure, have it for 16 weeks and here, take more money. I just don't see it.
Yeah, it's an issue, Kelly, because you remember also overlay that we're in an election year and you've got both sides fighting here to try to use this slyly. You know, they don't want to be overt about it, but there are political overtones to this thing. And, you know, you've got one side not wanting to reward big business here and calling it bailouts. We've got to be careful here. These are employers, right? Mm-hmm. Big business, small business, and we've got to take care of them. We've got to avoid the bankruptcies that will happen unless this liquidity is extended.
Well said. Steve, thanks for joining me. Appreciate it very much.